at the bottom of the depths of our awareness is the knowing, is the awareness that we haven't changed at all. And this is the drastic secret that we all carry with us as our baggage, buried, 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 and we try to bury it ever deeper. This is absolute sacrilege. This is the freak out that is within us. We have this complete freak out within us. And that's the realization, the knowing, that all of this dreaming, all of this imagining, all of this desiring it to be so, has not changed what we are in the slightest. And we try to belittle this awareness. We belittle it. And so it seems like there's this little tiny orphan there. We think it's just the dumbest, stupidest. We completely neglect it. So we think it's not worthy of any attention whatsoever. That's how insignificant we believe it to be. But inside, we're terrified. We feel there's some terrible something somewhere. We don't know what it is. And I'll tell you what it is. It's the awareness, again, that in spite of all our efforts, we have not been able to change reality in the slightest bit. The future has not impinged upon the now. Hasn't done anything to right now. So the spiritual path, one way to look at it, is to gradually raise up this tiny little infant that's so neglected here. Nobody will claim responsibility for it. To raise that up into fullness of our attention and saying, hey, I'm listening to you now. I'm listening to you now. I'm sorry I did not listen before. I forgive myself. I repent. I forgive myself. The neglect was really, I'm the one who paid the price for this neglect. See, it hasn't harmed reality. It hasn't harmed reality whatsoever. But we think it has. We think we've caused severe suffering for this little child. No, we've caused severe suffering for ourselves. Because of the fear of this little child. We're the ones who are afraid of truth. Lies are afraid of truth. Truth is not afraid of lies. So we've been afraid this whole time. We have to forgive ourselves for that. If it's doable. If Jesus says it's doable, it's doable. I feel this is coming on for me. All this time, belittling the truth within us and suffering terrible anxiety because it wouldn't go away. No matter what we do, it's still there. And we think ourselves to be stupid. We think ourselves to be incompetent. We think ourselves to be mythical. We believe ourselves to be irrational. We believe ourselves to be easily distracted. We believe ourselves to be, you know, blasphemous, heretics. We believe that for some reason we just don't have what it takes. All of this guilt trip we have on ourselves, we've put on ourselves because we can't get rid of this awareness somehow. We can't get rid of it. It's still there. We feel we're incompetent. So somehow the forgiveness has to come. And I felt it this afternoon or this evening. I felt, hey, I need to forgive myself. I can do that. Now, right now, I'm not feeling it quite as intensely because I'm putting this out structurally here, expressing it. But certainly, that's where it's at. That's where it's at. It's been a long road for me, 1978. I remember the dream. I picked up this little infant that everyone neglected. Nobody would accept responsibility for it. I was stuck with it. Wow. I said, I'm not going to be able to raise this infant up properly, believe me. It turned out this was the truth, the infant truth, the awareness of reality. And it showed this to me. And I said, wow, this is the divine infant, the divine child. But how am I going to raise this child? I don't know. Well, it's not me that has raised the child. It's the child that has raised me into trying to recognize, you know, it's the truth. It's the truth. It's not just a neglected infant. This is the voice of truth. This is the living light itself. It hasn't been changed. And so I've had to come to terms with this, gradually get more and more used to what it's saying. You know, that's why I spend all my time frantically, because I know I have this within me. I have this living light within me, and I got to get used to it and stop belittling it, you know? Stop turning away from it. So, the sooner the better, the sooner we forgive ourselves, the better it will be for us. But it's not something that we tend to think about very much. It seems difficult, but it's right here. I saw it. I said, yeah, I can do this. I can do this, sure. Just a matter of seeing what needs to be done. Absolutely, it's doable. Believe it, it is doable. So having seen it, what do? We get you. We just let that burn, let that wow reverberate through us and get used to it. I saw it, I can do it. Okay, it hasn't happened yet, it's going to happen. Just have faith in it. Don't struggle. Don't extrapolate into the future and say, okay, this is how it's going to happen. Don't struggle with the past or something, anything parallel to this moment. Just know that forgiveness is coming. It is absolutely on its way. Not a moment too soon, that is for sure. Because here comes another cycle where almost everyone is going to say, you know what, I really, really have to have at least another cycle to work on my incompetence. that's really what's going on. Okay, the people here in this world, they seem very smart, sophisticated, but it's very superficial. Inside, they feel extremely incompetent because they haven't found a way to get rid of this inner knowing. This inner awareness, they haven't. But they're very confident because they said, just give us another cycle and then I'm sure we'll get it. no problems. They have that sort of competence. But take away this other cycle from them and let them be right now. Let us be right now. And it's like freak out time. If they didn't have another cycle to completely freak out. But like for me, no more cycles. No more cycles. This is it. So I have to face it right now. So we're totally different, you know, destiny lines. Totally different destiny lines. They have a lot more confidence because they say, got another cycle coming up. Shed should do it. I'm nervous because I don't have another cycle coming up. So I got to do it now. That's the difference. That's the difference. So those on the spiritual path may seem less sure of themselves, nervous, you know, meek, very meek, like, wow, I don't know if I can do it. This is tough. And those who have another cycle seem to be very, very strutting around, like, ruling the roost. Say, what me worry? I got another cycle coming. What are you talking about, me worry? Not worried. Well, we'll see how that other cycle goes for them. And as they start drawing to the end of that cycle, do they want to enlist for another one? Because they'll still have this super, super huge continuity problem. And they'll say, oh my gosh, what do I do now? I don't want another cycle. So always the burn, the pressure is towards the end of the cycle for all us procrastinators, which we all are. This is where the rubber meets the road. This is where the tough get going. Going gets tough. This is where the tough get going because, you know, there's no tomorrow that we have to forgive ourselves. For all this neglect. And, of course, we paid the price for it. So forgiving ourselves is like, wow, I caused myself an incredible amount of suffering. But it's time to let that go. It is time to let that go. Vanish this awareness. And so I tried really hard to do it. And I failed. But the suffering has been a positive suffering. Because the suffering in accepting this awareness, even though it's been very stressful, is what has been leading to, actually will lead to tremendous bliss. So, forgive ourselves and also commend ourselves. Commend ourselves, absolutely. It's a commendable forgiveness. And again, don't struggle with words. It's the words cannot quite capture it at this moment. But to think that we, at one time, thought that we could change reality, that we could banish and vanish this awareness, that we could separate it from it. And to think that we actually wanted to do that, I think maybe that's the where forgiveness comes in. Wow, I forgive myself for wanting to separate from this. Wow, that's really something. So there is this forgiveness, this humility, this recognition. It's all this attitude that we're working towards here on the path. We're working towards it. We have to get to it. We have to get to it here. we just ask, say, inner awareness of the truth, I just ask that forgiveness comes upon me so that I may accept your message in fullness and give you the rightful place of honor that you deserve. We'll see what that does. There's a lot of trepidation here, for sure. But at least we can try. At least we can look at this. So, we won't go too long on this one. Sleep on it and see where we are in the morning. Very great. That's it.